is thanking Pics for being our sponsor, creating this event, and inviting us to come and share a little bit about what we do with all of you guys. And Bea has been a fantastic liaison between us and the company, and I'm really looking forward to what they do at the fair. So as she said, they're going to have a booth or a room, and they're going to have some of their Pics artists. They're going to do some kind of active activation where their artists will come down with the pictures and actually use and show how that works in the general public. So look for them when you come to the theater. I want to introduce my partner, Steve Zavattero, who's in a fantastic gallery for all the years and that's so much like this gallery. And I just want to tell you a quick little story about how the Start Art first started, and then I'll let Steve talk a little bit, and I think that's what we'll talk about. So over time, I used to have a gallery representation in LA in San Francisco, New York, and over several years, I lost all of my galleries through one means or another. I've been a working artist for about 20 years in the area, and I've taught art, and my work here, all across the country. One of the things that I noticed in the art world is understood about the art world lately is in the last 10 years, galleries have been falling by the wayside, but art fairs have been flourishing. And most business in the art world seems to be happening in these events or in cities. So one of the problems is if you're an artist without a gallery, though, you don't have access to art fairs and collectors and people that come to art fairs. So how do you, create a career or promote your career if you're not associated with a gallery? And I was looking for an art fair that I could participate in, one for individual artists. And in the United States, there are very, very few. So I called up Steve and I said, I have this idea. I want to create an art fair for independent artists. Now, mind you, I called a handful of other people, no offense. But Steve was the first one who said, I want to do that. Let's do it. And so we just created this idea to have a hotel fair. We found a hotel, and we made it happen. And it has been a wonderful success and a joy ride. And we took it down to LA in January. And now we're going to start our second edition So that's kind of a short story of how and why this idea has come to fruition.
It was one of those things. It's just we did a lot of art fairs as a gallery. I was involved pretty intimately with the art status, helping promote the fair to the galleries. I always enjoyed how art fairs seem to be, love them or hate them, they are a way to get work in front of a lot of people all at once and to be curated in different kind of perspectives. And, my gallery, unfortunately, had to close. Like many other galleries, I was one of the only galleries that closed over the past few years. I had a lot of artists who I solely represented or something without representation. So when Ray came up with the idea, I felt it was really a wonderful thing to try to pursue. That extra little push to try to navigate the new waters of the market, whether it be getting out of the studio or learning how to sell online or just getting in front of a crowd that sees art fairs, their eyes are open and they're new and hopefully to buy, or if not, just to discover new things. San Francisco went great, LA went fantastic. We were a few guys jumping into a big pool down there with five other fairs, but everyone in the game loved it. They stuck around. They wrote nice things about it, the artists that did it were thrilled. And again, all I can say at this point now is talk to the artists that have done the fair, because they're the best calling on behalf for how this model can work, doesn't. On that note, I want to introduce Pantea Karimi. She is participating in Start San Francisco 2016 coming up. And she is going to be exhibiting with another artist who it was together two persons. Exhibition, it's a juried art fair. It's not as you are, it's juried by a very well-known group of art Trade Museum, New Division, Togemon Gallery, one of my neighbors at 77th here, the New Bedford Art Museum, and the Neobar Art Center, as well as the Aoun Gallery. He has also been awarded both the School of Arts and Culture Grant and two creative capacity in Tottenham. The work can currently be seen in this great show called Pumpkin Kingdom, which is at the Cal State University Science on Turlock.
It started March 3rd. bad or I'll send you the better of the furniture. Without tipping your hand too much, because I know you want to send you a piece of mine. How did you people show their work in a space like that when there is no sure needs?
Well, first of all, the space for me looks like a home setting. Okay. So if I have a kind of client coming into that hotel room, if you're like, okay, this is what it's going to look like, is how it's going to look like to take my artwork to your home. That kind of felt really intimate and kind of realistic in some sense. But then Victoria and I talked about moving some of the furniture around and having some works just, you know, not necessarily on the wall, but just be ready to just, you know, show it to some people. And we are going to talk to them, and whoever is interested, they would like to see more. So we're going to be preparing to also bring some works to show them. Yeah, kind of story.
It's an interesting, your work together is interesting because I think there's kind of some fun elements connected.
Yeah.
And, but at the same time, like, she does these images of kind of domestic life.
Yes.
And then your work is more like she has made the conclusions.
Yes.
And
conceptual.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
So how do you see that working together?
We are supposed to talk about that on April 3rd. So we have a telephone conversation already lined up.
Yeah.
So we're going to decide about that on April 3rd. I don't want to say anything before I talk to
you. Right.
Well, from my position, when I look at the work just formally, I look at your work formally without thinking about the ideas behind it, I do see a lot of connections between shapes, colors, textures. And she uses technology in work in an interesting way, and I didn't notice until very recently, but she does think about photography. It looked always to me like it was mounted on some kind of substrate, but
yes.
I found out it's actually
yes.
printed right onto a woman.
Yes. She
and
does those, yeah, metal
yeah.
printing. Yeah.
So it's a new technology that's come up with all this digital technology that we have now. And it's kind of blown away because it looks like traditional, you know, seed prints or something like
sure.
that.
Sure. And I am into the history of technology.
Yes.
And how it started.
digital technology has infiltrated everyone's practices. There's very few people that don't use digital technology. Even people who look at their work and are like carvers or whatever, they're using something. You know they are. Either sourcing images online or they're using some application. When I got to first got in contact with Bea and decided to do this partnership, I downloaded Pics on my iPad.
Yeah.
This is very familiar.
Yes.
This is like Photoshop for your computer.
Yeah.
Right? You don't have to touch any filter, you just bring that filter in or whatever. Yes.
And you can also make collage with different options available right away to you, so you can decide which kind of route you want to go. I'm just going to start playing around with it and see what I can get out of that.
possible to exist solely in a digital age, or are there shows still important for the viewers?
Oh, it's very
shows
cool.
Such as this beautiful catalog. Catalog. See as much anymore. You know, created digitally, I'm sure, but yet.
Sure, yeah. But yeah, you just touch it. You know, for me, I do it all. I have a website, I have accounts, I post, I send emails, I call people, I have catalog like this, I have PDF version that I send. I do it all. I create posters, I have postcards, I have business cards, and it is so interesting. I was in a party and a woman, you know, asked me, what are you doing? Blah, blah, blah. I said, oh, I have my business card. She said, no, I don't take any business card.
Oh.
Just give me your name and website. She added to her cell phone. But then I am in some parties, people are like, do you have a business card? And I'm like, wow, yes. Challenging, yeah, for some artists if they're especially alone.
and see if there's any questions from our people out there. I know Robert has.
Well, Greg, as Greg knows, you all know, I'm very much all in what you are all doing. I participated last year in terms of tours, and if you want to give me again this year, I'd be delighted to. There's one thing, though, that I wanted to bring up for artists especially to think about, and that is that as a startup fair with these artists that are not represented, when I went to the fair last year, I asked a couple of artists quite innocently, how much is that drawing? And they said $2,000. I said, well, if it's the gallery, how much? And they said, it's $2,000. I said, if it's the gallery, how much do you get? And they said, $1,000. I said, so if you sell it at this fair, you basically get twice as much as if you would sell it at the gallery. Now, of course, the artists that participate in the startup fair have to pay to be in the fair, so they do have expenses. So I'm not necessarily saying that that artist should charge $2,000 for it, but maybe $1,250 or something, and use the point that the startup fair is a place to get in on the ground floor and get one of those works of art before maybe that artist is represented, and then walk to $2,000 more. And the idea that the artist should sell the work as if it were a gallery prevents the possibility, because my attitude when I was going around the art fair last year, I want these works to sell their work. I want the works to be moving out of those rooms. I want the people to buy them. But if the artist said, well, I had a work in a group show in gallery, $2,000, it should be $2,000 here, I'm going to protect my work. No, the point is, because they're in that startup fair, there's this marvelous opportunity to kind of buy the produce off the truck from the farm to the city, from the studio. And so that is a tremendous selling point for those artists in the startup fair. Because with any luck, some of the artists at the startup fair will be noticed by certain galleries, will be taken on by those galleries, and then that gallery will represent them, do all the legwork that you have to do yourself in terms of a lot of the PR and all of that, of which they receive their commission. But here's the opportunity to give those artists a chance to sell to collectors at so-called the ground floor. But if the artists continue to sell the works of art at like a high price, as if they were being sold in the gallery, they really hurt the prospects of selling the art.
Sure, no, it's a really great point.
It just makes sense, but a lot of the artists don't quite understand it.
Robert, is that a question?
It's just a comment, because I feel really bad for some of the artists.
You're very passionate about
price your art. Price your work.
Well, the artists have come there, a lot of many artists that do this start there have time in their face. The professional artists have worked in the practice for a very long time. The prices are pretty set. Well thought out. So I don't know if it's the price would go up if the gallery steps in or not.
As an art appraiser, as a part-time art appraiser, there's only one price for a work of art, the market price. And if you have two prices for your work of art, you are screwing up the market. We disagree.
I respectfully disagree.
There's a price here.
All at the
work one of a kind pieces? Are they all one
of a kind? Yes, they're all unique pieces. I'm a screen painter. I don't do editions anymore. They're all unique pieces. You take it home, it's yours, and I can never, even myself, do that again. Because my fingers change. I don't know why.
Lots of media buys, partnerships, including tours, you know, that various curators and consultants bring people in.
Cold calls from LA.
Cold calls.
Probably 100 galleries.
In LA, Steve, I mean, I won't even take any credit for this. I didn't call very many galleries. We probably did call hundreds.
Most
we had dozens of galleries,
so art institutions, people with collectors.
We want to bring curators, collectors, dealers.
Collectors come for the crazy compliment there for that. We use social media every single day. We post on all of our social media channels and ours today. Follow us out on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. My personal LinkedIn, Google, Pics, we focus on artists. Well, we can do that.
And I do like a once a week attending seminar just on these partnerships with companies like Pixar and other business entities help us spread the word and you know, I mean, getting articles written in the Chronicle helps.
Yeah.
So we
$25,000.